now known as Juneteenth and is a day commemorating and celebrating freedom. Understanding Juneteenth fosters empathy, appreciation for diversity, and a sense of shared struggle. In the fight for freedom, students can empathize to the experience of others and stand up against discrimination. It encourages them to create a supportive environment where everyone feels valued and respected, irrespective of their background.
Decades after the end of slavery for HBCUs to thrive, these institutions provided African Americans access to a quality education. And that education has enabled them, the students, to make important contributions to American society.
Watch us get down to this groove with the Afro-funk feel, while we get high to a rhythm with spiritual appeal. Expressions of freedom from the descendants of slaves. God gives us the strength for new horizons we must break. So as you struggle to catch the rhythm with your feet, ask yourself, can you dance to my beat? The rhythm, the rhythm, the rhythm is our power section. The freedom we feel in our soul. We dance to learn those lessons as our story continues to unfold. Our beat, our words, our melodies are gifts from the givers of those gifts. We're millions of jewels to which they have passed. So as you struggle to catch the rhythm with your feet, ask yourself, can you really dance to my beat?
The sons and daughters of off-balance walks and distorted body rhythms. We are a footstep generation. A generation that defeated journeys of oppression through acrobatic expression. When the tongues of freedom had conversations with the body languages of our golden region now. So how you like me now? Cause we are the souls clapping for the souls that are still dancing, that refuse to forget us, that let us relive history through dance floor circles, circulated the cycle of life. We were the light at the other end of Harriet's tunnel. The forefathers of seven moons before moonwalking got jacked. Son, before electric boogaloo gave you the shock. Son, before the songs of war marched in rhythms of foot patrol towards the sun and shook the earth before rocks could be steady. Thank you.
is worse criminalizes based on your skin color. It's being a student of color who finds themselves in positions that other people don't expect them to be in or expect that they themselves should be in. It's being a student of color who holds the truth that they can exist and even excel in a system, a world, that they demand to be better. So go forth with that dangerous knowledge. Fill those spaces, sit at tables, and set places for others like you to join. Let your existence be revolutionary, and if others find your existence disruptive, so be it. That is not your water to carry. Let your presence stand as a symbol of inspiration for the children of color who will see themselves in you. And as a call to our non-black and brown allies, there is a role that you play in this as well. You have to actively acknowledge and work towards creating spaces of inclusion and opportunity. It is not just enough to know, you must do. Every day, 365 days of the year. So you students, go on, dream, create, and world build. Be the change that you want to see. From one black kid to all the black kids in this room, I promise to set tables. I promise to dream big. I promise to world build. I am so proud of you. I won't promise it'll be easy, but I promise you are enough. So have the audacity. Exercise your privilege. Choose your path. And I'll meet you in the woods. Thank you.
Hey.
So here today, we'd like to highlight a young man's next step.
You better stand up.
causes your thinking to be rearranged? Could it be that you would understand this beat to which we dance a little more clearly had you been given a chance? Woo! So y'all struggle to find a feel with y'all beat. Ask yourself, can you dance to our beat?
My name is Charity Crawford. On July 4th, 1776, America declared its independence from Britain, making it official that we were now free. And by we, I don't mean we at all, actually. I mean white men. In fact, at the moment that the Declaration of Independence was signed, every single state in the Union legally practiced slavery. That being said, absolutely no black people were affected in any real way at all by American independence, and the 4th of July for us was just another day of picking cotton and being beaten. So where is our day? Well, let's talk about Juneteenth. You would think it maybe had something to do with the Emancipation Proclamation, which is a document that Abraham Lincoln signed on January 1st, 1863, declaring that all slaves were free. But no, not really. Juneteenth is actually June 19th, 1865, 2.5 years after that. We'll talk about why that is in a second, but first, let's talk about Lincoln freeing the slaves.
He ain't really do that at all.
The slaves freed themselves. The Civil War started in 1861, and between then and 1863, thousands of slaves escaped on their own and ran north to fight in the Union Army. Lincoln eventually realized that this was advantageous and thought,
if I say all the slaves are legally free, then maybe more of them will come fight on our side. And then, hey, the slave patrol can't take them back, we good. And
so then he created the Emancipation Proclamation, freeing all the slaves in the South. But that didn't matter because at the time, the South wasn't even part of America, so literally, you did nothing. In fact, in the North, in Maryland and Delaware, two states that he actually did have jurisdiction over, he didn't free the slaves there. He let them continue to slave during the Civil War. And that became one of the bloodiest wars in American history, killing more than 700,000 people, which is more than the Revolutionary War, World War I, World War II, and Vietnam put together.
So yeah, about 1 million people died in the war fighting about whether or not you should own black people.
Back to Juneteenth. So yeah, on April 9th, 1865, Robert E. Lee surrendered, officially ending the Civil War. And then the next week, on April 14th, 1865, Abraham Lincoln was shot because people were mad about that. And even though slavery was being completely eradicated from the South, there were still plenty of slaves in Texas. Literally hundreds of thousands of African Americans who didn't know that they were free were being kept in Texas because it was the farthest away from the Union's control. But then, on June 19th, 1865, General Granger and his army went into Galveston, Texas, and General Granger stood upon a balcony and announced to the entire city of African Americans below them that they were now. And the entire crowd erupted into black joy. Singing, dancing, shouting, crying, laughing. Black joy. So much so that the next year, those very same free black people went to celebrate under that very same balcony. This story of pure black joy isn't really told, and it's for many reasons. One of them is that shortly after slavery, when the Jim Crow laws started, black people weren't allowed to celebrate in public lest they be lynched. Black joy became illegal, punishable by death. Another reason we don't celebrate it is simply because America doesn't like to face its gruesome slave history, and so Independence Day is just more agreeable to everyone. And the honest truth is, even June 19th, 1865 wasn't really about black people. It was just a random day that a general decided to go flex his power on Texas and say, "You will obey America or else." That same general that spoke on that balcony on Juneteenth, in that very speech, he suggested that the newly freed slaves just go back to the plantation and ask for a job. So basically, just go back to doing the same thing you've been doing, but now you make a penny for your time. So no, not even that moment on June 19th was about us, but this holiday, Juneteenth, is ours. We as black people have mastered the art of turning pain into passion, of turning misery into music. And so Juneteenth is a celebration of our freedom, of our joy. Happy Juneteenth. I love you.